Hey, what's up, guys? It's Dark and Duels. Today I'm going to be doing a Skull Servant deck profile. So this deck is a really, really fun deck that's actually really budget, and it's been doing really good in Duel Links or Speed Dueling, one of the two. But it's a really fun deck to play around with that can make a humongous Skull Servant and just shows you the power of numbers. So this deck is a super fun deck, like I said, that making 10,000 attack point monster. It can go up, I think, to like 13,000, something like that. It gets humongous with just being able to summon the King of the Skull Servants and summon out a really big monster just off of normal summon. And it's a really fun deck that doesn't even really need an extra deck. Like, you don't even need this to play the deck. You can play it, and I do recommend having the extra deck, at least with the Link Rebos and a couple of the Synchro Monsters, but you don't have to have an extra deck to play Skull Servants. So without further ado, guys, let's get straight on this. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what you think of this video down in the comments down below, and let's get straight on into this. So, and don't forget to hit the bell right down there so you can become part of the notification squad. So, first off, we're going to be playing three copies of Skull Servant. So let me get that to autofocus for you guys really quick. So a Skull Servant is a skeletal ghost that isn't strong, but can mean trouble in numbers, in large numbers. And that's what's really amazing to me, is they actually, like, base the whole deck's effects and cards off of that flavor text. Because this deck literally does mean a big deal in numbers. So then we play three copies of King of the Skull Servant. Basically what you want to do with this card is you want to get as many of your Skull Servant cards that count as Skull Servant into the graveyard so you can get the added attack to this card, because this card gains 1,000 attack for each Skull Servant monster in your graveyard. And then when this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard or result of battle, remove from play one King of the Skull Servants or Skull Servant in your grave and then special summon it right back. So we're not worried about any effects going off that we're going to just special summon it right back and keep going with our plays. So then I play three copies of White Mare. White Mare is also one of those Skull Servant cards that when it counts as Skull Servant while in the field or in the grave, and then when this card is treated as Skull Servant, you can discard this card to activate one of the following effects. Either select one card that's removed from play, one of your removed from play Skull Servants or White Mares, and return it to the grave, or select one of your removed from play the Lady in Right or King of the Skull Servants and special summon it, which is really good to be able to just banish a King of the Skull Servant to special summon King of the Skull Servant, and then have White Mare in hand, discard White Mare, get it 1,000 points bigger, and then special summon back the King of the Skull Servants as well, which is really, really good. Then we play three copies of White Prince. White Prince is probably the big starter engine of the deck that I would have to say is the starter engine of the deck. If this card is sent to the graveyard, you get to send a Skull Servant and Lady in Right, basically his parents, to the graveyard, which all kids in the parents there, but anyways, through stress, but from your hand or deck to the grave, and then you can banish two Skull Servants from your graveyard in this card to your graveyard, special summon one King of the Skull Servants from your deck to this, and this card's name becomes Skull Servant while in the grave. So the really cool thing about this deck is it's actually a whole family, which is cool, because Lady in White is the mother, and then Skull Servant is the dad, and then White Mare is actually the kid, and then White Princess is the little girl. So it actually makes a whole family of skeletons. I mean, like, creepy, spooky skeleton family. Like, why not? It's a really fun deck, though. I cannot emphasize that enough. It's super fun. But the Lady in Right's effect is face up level 3 or lower zombie monsters you control, except Lady in Right cannot be destroyed by battle, and are unaffected by the effects of spell and trap cards. And this card's name becomes Skull Servant while in the field or in the grave. This was actually, I believe, the first one, along with, I believe... No, the White Mare came out later. Like, this came out, and then... No, it was Skull Servant, then King of Skull Servants, Lady in Right, White Mare, and then White Prince, and then White Princess. So this card's name becomes Skull Servant while in the field or while in the graveyard, and if this card is normal or special summoned, you can send one White Prince from your deck to the grave, and then during either player's turn, you can send this card from your hand or field to the graveyard, and all monsters currently on the field lose attack equal to their rank or level times 300, which can be pretty big and a lot of help in this deck. So then I only play two copies of Unizombie because I play three copies of Shiranui Solitaire. The Shiranui Solitaires just help me out to get the Unizombies onto the field so I can send White Prince to grave, because mainly what you're trying to do is get White Prince in grave to send the additional Skull Servants to the graveyard so you can continue special summoning. Then we play three copies of Mizuki and one copy of Gozuki. The reason you play these is because Gozuki just sends additional cards to your graveyard, and Mizuki revives your King of the Skull Servants and your Lady in White to get more plays off of them, and they're used for link summoning. Like, you can use these cards for link summoning as well. which can really assist the deck a lot. So that's it for the main deck monsters, guys. We're playing 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, so you can get it all the way up to 17,000 with just one copy of King of the Skull Servants on the field if you have all 17 other copies of this, all the other 17 copies of Skull Servant in the graveyard. And I really need to invest in the ultra rare versions of Skull Servant, but I like my LOBs. I like being able to say this deck is pretty much just a common deck. So, that's it for the main deck, guys, or the main deck monsters. Let's get into the spells. And like I said, this deck is super cheap. You can probably build this deck for maybe $30 for the main deck. Like, that might be it. Maybe 20. Like, I haven't looked it up, but I think you can probably build this deck for maybe $20. So it's pretty cheap. So then we play one copy of Monster Reborn. Monster Reborn's really good because you can just activate this and bring back King of the Skull Servants. Foolish Burial to send White Prince to graveyard to get two more in the graveyard. So you normal summon out Skull Servant with 3K. One copy of One for One because they're all level 1s and it doesn't matter. We can just special summon out King of the Skull Servants from our deck. Two copies of Foolish Burial, good because in case you use that White Prince's effect, you can put it back in the graveyard to give your Skull Servant 3,000 more attack, which is really, really helpful. Three copies of Where Arf Dal, because everything is level 1. If you control a level 1 monster, you can search a level 1 from your deck to your hand, which is pretty big in this deck, to be able to get those additional searches off. And Where Arf Dal is just pretty much made for this. I really hope that they do the dog, because in like White Prince's like artwork, you can see the dog, and you can see the dog in White Princess's artwork. So like, I really hope that they make the dog soon. Then we play three copies of Allure of Darkness. This card is basically everything in the deck is dark except for the Shiranui Solitaires and the Mizuki and Gozuki. So, and I believe the White Princess, and she's light for some reason. I don't know why she's light, but she is. Maybe she's the light of their life. I don't know. I know, being sweet. But you play Allure for Darkness because it's a good draw card in the deck. And then we finally play three copies of Called by the Grave because this deck, it's not really affected by hand traps that much. The only thing that's really affected by it is Ash Blossom. And if you can stop the one Ash Blossom for the turn, you can go off. And I mean go off on your opponent and be able to special summon out your copy of King of the Skull Servant with like One for One. Or heck, you can just normal summon it out and swing at your opponent for like at least 10k on the first turn to be able to just attack and go, I win. Like, that's it. And this card stops the named effects of all the Ash Blossoms. And usually you're just going to get hit with like Ash Blossom anyways. The only other card that really affects this deck is like Effect Veiler, because they can Effect Veiler your King of the Skull Servants, and then you just wait. You just wait, because you've already normal summoned it. And as far as I've checked, there's not any hand trap that says your opponent can't normal summon. So I'm not really worried about hand traps that much in this deck. And I'm not worried about hand trapping my opponent, because there's not many cards that just blatantly stop a normal summon. So I'm not worried about that. So that's it for the spells and the main deck, guys. Let's get into the extra deck. I'll go through the extra deck relatively quickly. It's not, like I said, not really needed. But I play double Link Rebo because everything's level 1 just about in the deck. And it's easy to go into Link Rebo and prevent your opponent from doing things while you're waiting to get your King of the Skull Servants. One copy of Link Spider. Now, the reason I play Link Spider in this deck is kind of a big brain 200 IQ thing. If you open up two Skull Servants, you can normal summon one, link it away, go into Link Spider. Link Spider effect activates, special summon the other Skull Servant, and then link these two away for another Link monster that is a Link 2. I know that card just went that way, and then back this way, and then that way again. Like, it's just all over the place. Skull Servants dancing. Spooky Scary Skeletons. Then I play one Wee Witch, just in case I need that extra 500-point boost. Just in case. Two Vampire Sucker. It's pretty much a generic in any vampire deck. One Cerberus to pop monsters. One Phoenix to pop spells and traps. Because these are the cards I use to go in with that Link Spider combo in case I open up Double Skull Servant in my hand. Nightmare Unicorn, just to bounce monsters. Boral Sword to OTK my opponent. Boral Load to OTK my opponent. Beals, because it's easy to make, because all you have to do is have Unizombie and send to your graveyard something that can be revived, like Mizuki, and have another level 4. Like, it's really easy to go into Beals. And Beals, a lot of decks cannot deal with Beals anymore. Like, they don't have just targeting removal. They don't have it. And they can't beat over him or destroy him by battle. And that's something that catches people off guard, because they're not so worried about that anymore. Because there was a time when Beals came out that everybody was like, no, I can't have anything that's really big, because I'm just going to not be able to beat over the Beals. And I can't have anything that just destroys like Dark Hole, because Beals is a thing. Because Beals used to be meta. So it's just a good generic Synchro Monster. So then I play one copy of Cyframe Lord Omega. Again, it goes with any deck that's a zombie deck. One copy of Boreload Savage Dragon. Boreload Savage Dragon's easy to go into in this deck with just Unizombie. It's really, really easy to go into this deck with a Unizombie. Because all you have to do is if you draw Shiranui Solitaire, you tribute it, and then special summon Unizombie, discard a card from your hand, or send a zombie monster from your deck to grave, like Mizuki, revive the Shiranui Solitaire with Mizuki, and then you synchro into either any of these that you want to. And then I had an idea of putting Chambara in here, because if you send, like, Mizuki to graveyard, and you have a Skull Servant on the field that's level 1, you can use the Unizombie plus a Skull Servant to go into Chambara, which is an option, if you want to go with that route. And I was just trying to find out some interesting tech cards that you can play in here. I think Chambara's actually had a reprint recently that made it go really way down in price. So that's it for the deck, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this one. It's a really budget deck, to be honest with you, except for the extra deck. You don't really, like I said, you don't really need the extra deck. It's there if you want it. You could definitely change up some of the cards that are more expensive, like Boreload, Borelsword. You could definitely take those out if you don't want to play them. But if you just want a fun budget deck, this is the deck for you, and it really catches people off guard. I really would love to take this to a locals and win with it. I think that would be hilarious, and go in with like a purple cape on. That'd be hilarious. I know it sounds really nerdy, but that sounds like something I would do. You guys know. You guys know me by now. So, anyways, guys, this is Darkroom Duels. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hit that bell down there so you can become part of the notification squad. Give me a like for this boy. He's even waving at you saying bye-bye. And I'll see you guys in the next video. See you around, guys.